Hello everyone, welcome back to Lucky Crit. Today we've got some brand new news about the upcoming Wave 3 and Wave 4 DLC for Fire Emblem Three Houses, thanks to a brand new Three Houses Perfect Guide, which is going to be a Famitsu guidebook published in Japan that has finally come out, and thanks to a Japanese fan and a user on GameFAQs by the name of Ein, we finally get to take a look at what is going to be coming out in the Wave 3 and 4 DLC. So just as a quick recap, we were promised 4 waves of DLC for Fire Emblem Three Houses. We've already gotten waves 1 and 2. Wave 1 was just simply the officer's outfit for male and female Byleth. That's all we got with that one. Wave 2 is what came out within the past week or so, which included a lot of interesting little things, including new glasses for Byleth, as well as new outfits for your students, basically loungewear is what they called it, which makes them look like sports players or they're on a sports team, which is kind of cool. Also, new stat-boosting items and auxiliary battles also came out with that Wave 2, including a brand new Corridor of the Tempest music track. So there were a lot of little things with that one, and we also saw that there will in fact be free DLC alongside the actual Expansion Pass DLC as well, as everybody, no matter if you bought the Expansion Pass or not, received the free game update, which had a lot of bug fixes and stuff, and also added the brand new Manating mode. Now, a lot of people are speculating that we'll also see a future Infernal or even harder difficulty, as in previous Fire Emblem games, there were usually 2 difficulties above hard. I think we actually ended up getting Wave 2 a little bit earlier than they had said. I think it was supposed to be for October, was the original timeline plan, but we ended up getting it just alongside some of the other fixes. There was actually a pretty interesting bug that happened with the game pretty recently, in that anybody who tried to, I think, purchase the expansion pass or something between a certain time frame within the past week or so actually kind of messed up their game, and you'd either have to uninstall the game or do something else in order to kind of fix it. And so thankfully there was a bug fix that was released alongside this stuff, but they also decided to drop the Wave 2 with that update recently, so that was kind of interesting. Wave 3 is looking to be released by December 31st, 2019, so we'll probably see that, honestly, if they're going to keep doing it pretty early, maybe within the next month or so, maybe like November or something, but definitely by the end of the year. And for Wave 4, we're going to be expecting that by April 30th, 2020. And Wave 4 is going to be the really big stuff. Now, for Wave 3 and Wave 4, what we can expect, thanks to the users who shared this new Famitsu Perfect Guidebook page, it's looking like the Wave 3 will include free DLC of a new playable unit in Yuritsa for certain routes only, new support conversations, probably due to Yuritsa being in the game now, and new activities and new online features. So, I don't want to delve into spoilers or anything, but it's really interesting that Yuritsa is now a playable character. I think that's going to be kind of interesting to see how he fits into the game and everything like that with his role that he already had within the story. So that's going to be really cool to see. And as far as paid DLC, we're looking at new playable unit Anna, new monastery facilities, new online, presumably, features. The translation's a little rough there, but probably some new online features, which I'm stoked about. Anna and Yuritsa Paralogue, and about 10 new quests alongside new activities, including a sauna for the monastery. That's pretty sick. Honestly though, they've kind of avoided pandering and fan service up to this point, aside from tea time, which was handled pretty well. So I'm gonna be really, really interested to see how they pull off the sauna, if they're gonna go full fan service with this, or if it's gonna be kind of more tasteful, like tea time was. That's gonna be really cool to see. And there's also gonna be playing with dogs and cats. So honestly, I was planning on making a meme on the channel, just a crap post at one point in time talking about how you shouldn't buy the game because you can't actually pet the animals. Guys, it looks like we're going to be able to pet the animals. So a lot of people's dreams have now come true, and by the end of this year, their lives will be complete. That is perfect. Also, some new costumes, Maid and Butler and more. And also new battalions, Maid and Butler battalions. I mean, I guess we could have seen that coming. We've got some characters that are basically retainers, kind of like in Fire Emblem Fates. So Maid and Butler outfits and that kind of stuff. It kind of works. It kind of works. And for Wave 4, so by next April 30th, 2020, we're looking at a new side story Abyss mode. I just want to pause for a second here with this. I don't think that that's actually going to be like an abyssal difficulty. I think a lot of people are jumping to that conclusion, but the fact that it's a side story doesn't make it seem like that to me, unless that's a rough translation or something. That honestly seems like it might be like an extra story mode, maybe beyond the game's main story, that you can take like maybe a game completed save file or something like that and go into. I'd be really interested to see what happens with that, but we were promised new story elements, so not just a new difficulty mode. Hopefully alongside the Wave 4 DLC, we will see an even harder difficulty mode, because I'd love to see something beyond Madden. Madden is challenging, and a lot of people are really enjoying it so far. But typically in Fire Emblem games, we tend to have hard mode and then two higher difficulties beyond that. Sometimes like Lunatic and Lunatic Plus, and all sorts of stuff like that. They've begun changing the names in recent entries, so I don't know what it's going to be called. But I would definitely be looking forward to having another free DLC for Wave 4, including that even harder difficulty mode. I think that would be awesome. So this definitely looks like, to me, a side story or an extra part of the story. I was kind of hoping for extra branching paths in the storylines originally. I guess that doesn't necessarily work because they'd have to actually patch over game data and change maybe an event or two in the game or something. I don't know how that would work. But it's looking to be a side story, in my opinion. I think that's probably what that's going to be. So maybe extra story and extra events that happen after the main story of the game. Otherwise, you know, just a side plot. And also new playable characters Urias, Balthazar, Constanza, and Javi, or Javi. And those are tentative translations, so they'll probably end up changing by the time we hear them. And as far as I'm aware, these are brand new characters that have nothing to do with the game, at least... I'm a scrub. I haven't completed the game yet. You guys following my Let's Play know that. I'm a bit farther than in those Let's Play episodes I have out. I'm going to be getting back to that at some point soon. But yeah, I haven't beaten the game yet. But my assumption is these are all brand new characters. And new support conversations are also coming with this Wave 4. Most likely involving these characters. New monastery facilities once again. So another wave of monastery facilities that are going to be added to the game. This is going to like... Imagine future Let's Plays of this game. You will have so many more facilities available to you. This is gonna constantly keep changing, and I love that. I think it's gonna create so many more reasons to keep replaying this game and keep it fresh for people. That's amazing. Also, new online features again in Wave 4. Four brand new classes. Can't wait for that. A lot of people have been kind of discussing some issues with the class system, and I would definitely agree. I do think it's a little restrictive when... You know, the rest of the game is pretty open as far as what equipment you want for your characters and stuff, what weapons, and how you want to build your characters. So we could definitely use some brand new classes, I think, to further flesh that out. New enemy monsters, new hero relics. Now, these could presumably be for these brand new characters as well. In fact, there are some crests that do not appear in the game, as far as I know. Even though we've seen the crests, we know that they're a part of the bigger picture here, but there are no characters within the game who actually bear these crests, so this is going to be pretty interesting to see. I actually think that Anna has one of these distinct crests as a part of her outfit, so perhaps Anna as a playable character within Wave 3 will in fact have that particular crest and be able to use one of these relic weapons, and maybe these other four characters are the other crest bearers. That would be pretty interesting, I think. So brand new hero relics, new paralogues, new quests, new battalions, new gambits, and once again, new costumes for Byleth, male and female, and also Sothis this time, so that's pretty interesting too. So overall, this is looking to be pretty amazing. I think a lot of people are going to be satisfied with this. Honestly, I really wasn't expecting Anna to be another DLC character like she was for Awakening and Fates. It was a nice little trend, and a lot of people really like Anna as a character, and as a character who consistently pops up, you know, in most of the Fire Emblem games. But this time with Three Houses, this is the game that really seems like they wanted to break a lot of that tradition and do a lot of very different stuff. So I really honestly didn't anticipate seeing Anna as a DLC character again. I don't know. I guess I should have. But in this case, looks like we are going to be getting her as well. So Anna and Yuritsa, as well as these new guys by next April... This is looking pretty great, guys. I'm pretty stoked about this. It's pretty exciting. I honestly hope, though, that we'll continue to see further bug fixes and updates to the game as well as part of the free DLC content, because I think, you know, the game in general, I love the game, but it's definitely a little poorly optimized, I think. I don't know if that's a hardware limitation of the Switch or just the fact that they use the Warriors engine for this game, and so it's using an engine it wasn't really built for. I'm not so certain on that one, but it definitely seems a little... choppy with the way that some stuff works, and especially with some of the slowdown around the monastery. I think that's pretty unfortunate, and I just wish it would run a little bit smoother. I think that would be really cool. So I hope that we will continue to see further fixes and updates like that as well. But here are the four waves of DLC. I would love to know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Now, of course, this information could also be subject to change. This is quite a ways out still at this point, and this guidebook had to be published, you know, for around the game's launch for right now, basically. about a month and a half after the game came out. So there could be further changes. There could even be further stuff that they add later. But we were only promised these four waves of DLC, so it's up in the air as to whether or not we'll see anything else. We also know, thanks to some of the data miners, that there are characters that were fully fleshed out as actually built characters that are not currently recruitable or acquirable within the game. And it doesn't seem like these characters are actually going to be a part of any of these waves of DLC. So that's pretty interesting that at some point in development, they actually fully fleshed out these characters and made them playable units, basically, with all their animations and such. I don't want to get into spoilers as to who these characters are, but they're not included here, which I find pretty interesting. So perhaps we could end up seeing that, or maybe these are just characters that were scrapped during the development of the game that maybe at one point in time were planned to be playable. But aside from that, I definitely want to know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Please let me know, what is your favorite part about this DLC? What are you excited about? And maybe what you wished that they would have also included alongside this stuff. But definitely be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Do you have a favorite part about these waves of DLC? Is there something that you wish that they would have included that they won't be including, at least as far as we know so far? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Please let me know. Once again, as always, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one. I'll be back really soon with some more Let's Play stuff, some more guides. A lot of you guys enjoyed my Blue Lion student guide, which you can check out here. I'll be back and hopefully doing some more of those for the Golden Deer and Black Eagles, of course, and also some teachers and other stuff like that that I'll be sure to throw that in there too. So be sure to stay tuned on the channel, get subscribed if you haven't yet, and I'll be back really soon. So see you later, guys.